As a director, time is your biggest enemy. And the thing about this, the speed at which we're able to move and the amount of setups, that's honestly the dream. The ability to find new shots on the stage is just incredible. We can really get to the core of what a scene is about and then use the volume to help tell that story.
One of the things that excites us most, of course, about this is that the fact that we can do in-camera choreography where all the elements of the frame are actually in concert with one another and organically working off of one another to create a more visceral experience.
If an actor has an idea or a camera operator wants to reframe the shot, you can make those alterations in the moment, and everyone is working in a very tactile way.
In the same amount of time that it would take me to change a light in the physical world, I'm able to have new lighting on the wall. As a director, that's a game changer.
It's so much easier now to be able to make the changes in real time, see their effects, and then make adjustments from there.
And it's immediate, you know? So your whole world that you're shooting in is changeable.
It allows for a happy accident. It allows for more spontaneity in the creative process.
So from day one with virtual production, you know, we build a real-time engine. We want to make sure that all processes are real-time or can happen incredibly quickly. In the moment, you change your mind, you want to change the light, you want to move the rock, you want to do stuff right in front of your eyes. You know, what's the point of deploying real-time technology if you don't have a real-time feedback loop?
The really exciting thing about this is the fact that we're not pushing everything to the end anymore. This isn't something that like, oh, we'll just deal with it later. We're making those decisions with our entire team, our production designers, our DPs. Everybody is there on set working on this stuff together.
It's not separated into components of pre-production, shoot, and post-production. Usually you just have your physical set that you're standing on and the screen is behind you and you just kind of give it over after you're done shooting and you hope that it all works out.
Once principal photography ends, post takes over, and if you're not part of that, everything that you've really envisioned and that you've designed goes through a filter and doesn't always come at the other end in the way in which you envisioned. With this, you have the virtual art department with control of the concept designs all the way through to final pixel.
I have to admit, I was skeptical when I first came here, but 4 or 5 days into it, I am totally blown away with how you can move things around, how we can change sun direction, how I can physically change sets. We're taskmasters, and it's all about time. If I lose an hour on a commercial or a movie, I can't get that time back. And that could be $100,000, or that could be $500,000. We shot 4 sets over the course of 4 days, 4 big sets. I mean, they looked gigantic. And then we realized we didn't have shots that we wanted. I went to the guys and I said, all right, I need the cave entrance, I need the spaceship set, and this is how I'm gonna do it. So not only did we shoot all those big set pieces out, but I'm gonna shoot all those pickups. And this in between the sets is 20, 30 minute setup. It was photoreal and it was ready to reel. That means that you could go from shooting it to projection in the same day. That's technology at its finest.
I don't think there's any turning back. When silent films are going to speaking, you better learn how to start speaking.
If it was up to me, I would shoot like this on every production. I love it. I absolutely love it.
Feels like we're moving from like, you know, filmmaking 1.0 jumping to filmmaking 5.0. And I don't see any other path forward that is nearly as exciting, compelling, or freeing for artists as this path.